Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Adam's Quest. In the last episode, we found a brand new wanderer sneaking around in our swamps and stealing our food too, of course. But since then, Izmi has been an absolutely wonderful help to the rest of the tribe, especially when it comes to teaching our youngest generations. So she has spent most of her life inside the swamps and in the jungle, so that's why we figured she must be some sort of expert in sneaking. She even has the velvet paw, so she's super, super quiet, and she knows the general lay of the land too. So she's teaching the children how to keep themselves hidden so predators out in the grass won't be able to find them. Luckily, this place remains the same safe haven that it was before. We still don't have any apes to worry about, so I think we're going to be okay. There is still a little bit more jungle that we could explore over here, but in all honesty, if there was an ape in the grass, we probably would be able to hear it or smell it by now. So that means that the jungle family should be able to continue clearing out their paths in peace, because today is the day that Ronuta is going to start bringing the rest of the tribe over to the north. He has finally assumed the role that his mother intended for him all along. He's taken on both of those bluebird feathers, so he's officially ready to become their leader and lead them on to the next great migration. So the first thing he's going to have to do is round up all of the creatures down in the south. We have Toadstool and Pine starting their own little family too. So I think he's probably going to stay behind for a little while. He's going to want to make sure that the baby can make its way out of the nest after all. Little Ruby is very, very important to the future of our tribe because she's the very first creature we've ever had with the claw. So all of Pine's training paid off, and I'm sure she's going to make sure that her baby is just as well trained as she was too. So maybe Ronuta would ask his big sister Issa if she wouldn't mind taking point. Since somebody does need to lead the rest of the creatures off to the north, she'll be the one to scoot her way to the front and make sure there's no danger in their path. That means she'll get the chance to meet Amanita too. Amanita, who has stumbled her way straight into Rokirnu and Lasila because she was a little bit worried that they required some assistance. Lasila found that she loves the water. We knew that she was connected thanks to those itty-bitty ripples on her back, but she got her first taste of the stream just yesterday when she dove in, cannonballed straight into the stream without Rokirnu's permission. So he was quite worried, but in all honesty, she is having the time of her life. And she even found a new little koi friend down here who I think might actually be dead. Yeah, looks like he's not moving around too much. So why don't we go ahead and collect the dead clown koi for the extra food? She might actually be a pretty good clown koi hunter since she looks so much like one herself. Maybe if we're lucky, we can even get our hands on some of those fishing related genetics. Maybe we could find somebody with a fishing tail to breed her with, or maybe we could even unlock it in the mutation menu. I'm not actually sure what it takes to unlock the fishing tail. Oh, just fish 30 times. Alright, so maybe Lasila will be able to have some angler babies after all. It must run in the family, of course, because Issa was always hoping to get her little paws on some fish of her own, but she wasn't quite as lucky. So we could bring her up here and maybe she could try again. She could use her last turn to try to scoop up some fish, which won't be quite enough. They're still a little bit too slippery for her, but it's all for a good cause because you are getting us a little bit closer to our goal. And look at this, the rogue male is visiting again. So we did ask that you stayed away from our tribe, little one. I know you must be getting a little bit lonely without the original blind wanderer to stand by your side, but we don't want you getting to our females. In fact, I think we'll bring Pine over here, so she'll be able to breed with Toadstool again, but this guy is getting dangerously close to some of our other females too. So Button is not going to stand for this, and neither will Ronuta. If you can't hold up your end of the bargain, then we will have to attack. It's one of the many tough decisions that he knows he's going to need to make as a leader. So we'll see where this guy ends up going, and we'll just keep a very close eye on some of our unprotected females, like Amanita, of course, and even Tara back here, who is just trying to make sure that her mentor's grave is kept well protected. She held a lot of love for Vanta, of course. She left her family at a very young age too, so I guess you could say that Vanta was kind of like a father figure to her. She didn't really know her own father as well as she knew Vanta, after all, and Vanta taught her quite a bit about life in general, how to hunt, how to chase down those bunnies. So Toadstool, if you wouldn't mind, maybe you could gather up some of the last of our food? And then we'll have Pine gather up the family nest as well. We're going to want all of these creatures to pack up their nest to prepare for the big move, because we'll definitely need them once we get to the new island. Now I think it might be time for us to take a look at the mutation menus for Rokirnu and Amanita as well. Their babies are actually likely to be super, super healthy if they do start a family together. They have completely different immunity genes, and they also have perfect eyesight. So that's one less thing that we have to worry about. I do think that we might want to put some ram horns in their genetics, because that's the only type of horns that we have available to us right now. We actually have to spend time in colder climates to unlock the antlers, so that's still quite a ways away. The ram horns will do the exact same thing though, and of course it is the crown that connects them to Animeme, our goddess of war, so that's always a good thing to keep tucked in your back pocket. Since they both have the poison fangs, we already know that their babies are guaranteed to be little balls of poison too, so I'm super excited for that. Which works out well for Amanita anyway, because she does love to sample all of the exotic fruit that she can find. So now her babies are also going to love the taste of poison berries, which can often be a very acquired thing. Oh my goodness, Lucilla found a little friend after all. How cute is this? It's almost like it's her little pet. It's probably not going to stay around for very long because those clown koi can be very, very wiry. But this is the cutest thing ever. No wonder Lucilla loves the water so much. If she can find good friends like that. But let's have Rokirnu go ahead and pick up some of his very final berries, and then we can bring Amanita over here to breed with him. We'll move her up a little bit further before she has her baby, because I don't want her to hang around too close to where the rogue male was, and I also want her to be much closer to the north, because we don't want her baby to be too far away from the ports. And Truffle, it looks like you have a little bunny to snag up too. I guess it didn't see you. It must be because of your coat color, actually. The moss brown fur does affect the camouflage. I wonder if he has a little bit of a boost. A very, very tiny boost, but it seems like this color is perfect for the grasslands tile that he's on. So clearing out the grass over here might be the perfect task for you after all, and we can have Needle do the same thing. She can scoot right up here as long as her baby is safe. In fact, we might want to have him toddle his way out of the nest, sit right next to his father, so he can scoop up the extra material and then send Needle off exploring. And what a perfect place to find! She actually found another one of these permanent nests right inside the haven. So this has to be the best place for us to set up a brand new family. It's right next to the ports too, so if we have any last-minute babies being born, this would be an excellent location. And not only that, but we also have a bunny hopping on the shore. So are any of the kids able to make their way over there? I mean, Dusk is probably the closest, but she's not going to be able to pounce on the bunny. But she has confused it. So we can swipe it from behind, and then we could have your mother gather up the food. So your very first kill, Dusk. I guess you also have a little bit of the huntress in you too. It seems like you're going to be quite the valuable hunter to take along with us on our journeys. Camo in the meantime prefers to work a little bit more quietly, so we'll have him carve out these paths, and that gives Izmi a good opportunity to look for some more roots, I think. She should be able to get around a little bit more easily now. So do we have any more roots in the jungle? We do have one right here, that's good. We have one way back here too, but that's a little bit close to the swamp for my liking. I'm still not sure if we're going to run into any of those bugs, but it's not something that I want to see Izmi fall prey to. So let's bring her over here to dig up this root, and then I guess we could bring her a little bit closer to the south, because we do have some roots down here that we haven't touched yet. And that'll give her the chance to meet some of the other members of our tribe. So we'll bring her down to the swampy barrier, and on the next turn, hopefully she can gather up a little bit of extra food. And honestly, little guy, you're being very, very risky right now. This is not Button's first experience with a rogue male, though. He was actually the one who took out the rogue male that was kind of terrorizing his own family way back in the day, when he was just a little child himself. so maybe he would send out one warning bite to this rogue male. One warning bite to poison him too, so that he shouldn't be hanging around our creatures for very much longer. I'm kind of surprised that he's running back out though. Really, little guy? That's not a good direction to go in. We could have Ronuta come up here at least to try to scare him away. He might even have to block him from the side so he doesn't get too close to our other females. And with a very watchful eye, we'll have Rokirnu pick up the last of his grass before we go ahead and skip the day, because I think everybody is all tired out now. So let's watch all of the grass in the corners too to see if any little carnivores are going to be sneaking out today. It doesn't look like it. We still have not seen a single carnivore on this island, which I think is a little bit surprising. Oh, and do we have another rogue male over here? Oh, that's a little bit of a worse situation for us. He is on the other side of the stream, though, so we might be able to get our females away before he becomes a problem. That being said, if he does have a new immunity gene, then he might actually be somebody that we want to get to know. But I think it might be time for Lucilla to make her way out of the water and maybe find a different stream to play in a little bit closer to the north. Now, unfortunately, sweet little Ruby still only has one gem, so she won't be able to make it very far. So we can settle down Pine right next to the berry bush. That way she'll still be right next to her baby too, and we won't have to worry about her getting hurt. Toadstool might as well come over here to pick up the berries for his mate, and that way he can keep a close eye on this guy too, the rogue male, to make sure he's not causing any trouble. Honestly, so far it just seems like he wants the company. He must be very, very lonely, and it must have been hard for him too when Ronuta passed away. For that matter, just delivering Ronuta to our doors must have been a very hard decision to make. He knew that Ronuta, because he was blind, needed some stronger creatures to keep him safe. And he's already seen firsthand just how lethal our tribe can be with Button's little snap of warning. So let's make sure that the rest of the tribe is safe too. We want to bring Rokirnu up this way so he can protect his sister and his mate, and then I suppose we could also have Ronuta start carving his way up front because he knows that the baby will follow as soon as she's able to. Button could even offer to stick around instead, which will give Ronuta plenty of reason to assume that everybody is going to be safe and sound, and now he could actually clear a little pathway so we can get around a bit easier in the swamplands, which is exactly what Izmi was planning on doing too, since we do want to find her some of those roots. And we have a little bunny over here, so maybe she could call out to Dusk, one of her apprentices, that there's some food that she could possibly pounce on right in the swamps. There you go, you chased it down pretty good, little one. Izmi might not be a huntress, but I'm sure she's still very, very impressed. We do know a different huntress though, and Tara was close enough that she might have actually been able to see that for herself. So maybe we could bring her over here to pick up that meat for her, and she might offer to help train up Dusk too. Teach her all the ins and outs of bunny hunting, kind of in a Vanta's memory. I'm sure it's exactly what he was hoping for. He doesn't want her to stick around and mourn at his grave forever. So since we had so many bunnies by the shore, we'll have her scoot her way back here, and as she helps the jungle family clear out their grass, we'll see if she can sniff out any little bunnies. Oh my goodness, bunnies and moles absolutely everywhere. I don't think it'll be too hard for us to find a little bit of extra food for Dusk to hunt up. But now that Izmi has a safe pathway to get to her roots, I think she's feeling a little bit more shy than she was expecting. All of the roots she wanted to dig up are right next to these strange creatures that she's never met before, so maybe we can bring her over here to hide away in the grass for a little while and startle the bunnies too. So she can observe these strangers from the safety of her hiding place, which is a habit that she picked up while she was on her own. Just like when we met her, once she's ready, she'll come out and greet these creatures fully. But we could have Issa maybe try to get the bunny instead. I think it's actually going to get trapped on some of the thorns, so she might be able to chase it down if she's lucky. For that matter, the bunny might not even notice her as soon as she gets in the grass. There we go, look at all these bunnies. Oh my goodness, maybe we want Amanita to come up here too? She only had one taste of meat, and that was back when she met the hunters for the first time way down here by the stump. So this is going to be nice for her to feast on something a little bit different. She's the type of creature who would probably get really tired of having just the same food over and over again. She needs a little bit of variety in her life. So all that should be left is to just continue clearing out our pathways. We have another little bunny down here though, so Needle, do your stuff. Grab that bunny for your baby. Oh, and we have a Vanta II sitting right next to Terra too. How fitting is that? I wonder if a Vanta II would also be interested in learning the ways of hunting. He does have the nimble fingers, so he seems like he would be more of the collecting sort, but maybe after hearing the stories of the great Vanta himself, he would be a little bit more interested in proving his own abilities. But that leaves everybody all tired out, so let's go ahead and skip the day again. And then hopefully this time we'll be able to bring Amanita up to the lovely little nest right in the safe haven so she can finally have her baby. And I'm pretty sure that yelp of pain was just the rogue male in the grass, because he is, of course, poisoned thanks to Button's warning. So I don't think we have anything to worry about. None of our creatures are injured anyway. So let's move Amanita up to the nest. If there's any safe place to have her baby, this would be it. And she's protected by so many other creatures, even her little brother. Amanita actually hasn't seen Truffle in such a long time. She's going to be quite surprised to find that he's all grown up now, and he even has his own little Spotty family too. Spotty and Spiky, of course. They're all very, very spiky with those big, prickly porcupine spines on their backs, just like Needle. So let's have you continue clearing out more of this grass right around the nest. That way somebody else could use that in the future. And look at this super colorful grass. Oh my goodness. We'll have to have Camo come over here and gather that up. That would be the perfect thing for us to decorate one of our nests with. If we ever wanted to catch Takir's attention, we know exactly what to use. Now as Rokirnu comes up here to join his mate to see the birth of their very first baby, and as Lysiela returns to the stream, of course, returns to on the water side because I'm sure she's missing her little koi clown friends, we might have a sweet little Izmi finally make her way out of the grass to meet Ronuta in full, and of course to dig up that tasty root that she's smelling down there too. She doesn't want to lose track of this. So maybe she could offer him this root as kind of a peace offering, a little offering of her friendship, because I'm not sure if he's ever tasted the roots before. We've certainly never had a digging pod creature in our tribe, so it's something very unique and something that he knows will be super helpful for the future. And then maybe we could have Ronuta come over here to offer the berries to her in turn, since she did give him her very first root, and it's a little bit trickier for her to pick the berries anyway with that digging paw. So I bet she would really appreciate a sweet little treat. Now let's make sure that everybody down in the savannah are still making their way toward the rest of the tribe. Now Ruby can move really far, excellent. So let's have you scoot your way right to the water side. We'll have Toadstool pick up the very last of the berries, even on these shriveled up bushes too, because you never know how much food you're gonna need on a new island. Now I think we're just down to our newest little hunting party. So maybe Terra would have them make their way down the shore, again because we find a lot of bunnies here, but also because it seems like we have one scooping up some berries very, very close to the ports. So it would also be a good opportunity for them to start clearing away straight to the ports themselves. We could even have Needle help out too, since I'm sure she would like to help teach her children. So let's bring them all straight down to the beach. We'll have to make sure that we change Vanta's gems over to his family's pink color too. And then maybe he could scoop up a few berries for good luck before he settles down right next to his mother. Now of course, Terra is going to have to take point on this mission. We'll have her sit in the grass and then sniff around again to see if we can find that bunny. It seems to have skittered off a little bit further, but I'm sure we'll be able to hunt it down again. It actually looks like it probably picked off all of the berries on that bush, so it probably moved on to find something a little bit more substantial to eat. But we do have a bunny sitting on the ports themselves. I guess that one's looking to leave for a new island too. So Needle, I guess you get to show your stuff after all. We'll have her pick up the very first bunny of this mission, and then I think we're ready to skip the day. So let's come over here and see what our next little mushroom baby is going to look like. It's been quite a while since we've seen a new mushroom baby after all. Oh my goodness! You are so pretty. Yet again, a perfect creature for the mushroom family. I love that they all have those adorable spots. So somebody suggested the name Portabella for our little mushroom family, just like the Portobello mushroom. So sweet little Bella will make a wonderful addition to the very, very hungry mushroom line. And she even has the home island immunity gene too, so that's good to see. We do have quite a few creatures who still have this in their genetics, so don't worry guys, even little Ruby has it too. We have plenty of home island immunities to take along with us to Adam's old island. Now I think the first thing they're going to want to do is pick up lots and lots of poison berries to feed to their new baby. And thankfully, since they all have the poison fangs, none of them have to worry about any of that toxic juice. Ruby, on the other hand, is raring to go. I think she really wants to start her own training. And in fact, we could use some of these berry bushes that we pass along the way. We'll want to swipe them up before we leave anyway, so why don't we scoot Ronuta over here, and then we can bring Ruby a little bit closer to the bush itself. We could even set up Pine right next to it too, so she can teach her all the best ways to attack. All of the skills that she's amassed over the years. And now with the next island just barely visible off in the horizon, it seems like the perfect time for Ronuta to start his family after all. So let's make sure that we of course keep a very close eye on Ismi's terrible eyesight. We'll have to place the normal eyes into one of her slots, but then as always, since this is part of our royal Adam family line, we'll make sure that we place the stripes into her mutation menu too. That way it'll be a little bit more likely that we'll see them on their babies. She does actually have the stripes hidden in her genetics, so it's possible that they could get pulled out anyway, but I'm really hoping that we're going to be able to hold on to some of her more unique genes, like the toxic body for instance, which we've never seen on any of our other creatures before. We'll make sure that we plop the ram horns into Ronuta's mutation menu, just for that tiny little extra boost in strength. And then we'll have him use his turns to breed with her so she can settle herself down in one of the nests right inside the safe haven. She might be able to make it all the way over to the one that Truffle is sitting on, the one that he's been keeping very well protected. There we go. You can settle yourself down right amongst friends too so they can all see your brand new little baby, the next baby in the line of Adam. We'll bring Ronuta over here to get to know some of the young generation as well. Since his babies might be playing with little Bella pretty soon, he'll want to get on good terms with the mushrooms. Somebody's sneaking up awfully close again. It seems like he really doesn't want to be all alone. Well, we might actually have to chase him out of the territory because I don't like him getting super close to Issa. Unfortunately, they both have the same immunity gene A, so that would risk sick babies. The rogue males can be okay as long as they have new immunity genes, but this is a case where we don't want him to get too close to our tribe. And speaking of nuisances, it does appear that we have a little bunny stealing our berries again. As always, we can never get rid of them, so let's bring Button over here to guard this berry bush for us. And then we'll take a quick trip back to the hunters, of course, to see if they've had any more luck finding bunnies. Oh yeah, Tara does smell one off in the grass. So this might be your chance, Dusk. Maybe you can grab this one too. It might actually be a good idea for us to have Vanta light up the way for her, if he can get a little bit closer. Or maybe for that matter, he could go around the back end. That way we can scare the bunny out into the light, so Dusk can actually grab it right from behind. We don't even have to worry about fiddling around with all of this grass after all. So you two make quite the duo. I think Tara's going to want to make sure that you're always hunting together. It would be a good idea to keep the party in the same place. But Camo, as ever, is far more interested in picking up all of these curly little vines that he finds around the jungle. He is definitely not the hunting type, but it takes all kinds in a tribe like this, and he's done a wonderful job clearing out the safe haven. So now we can truly call it a very, very safe place for all of these brand new little babies, and it looks like Needle is going to be the very first one to start clearing out the ports after all. So how many spaces do we actually have to work with? It looks like just like last time, we have 10 ports, so that means we'll be able to take 10 of our creatures with us to the next island. So we'll go ahead and skip the day for now. We'll see what the very first new royal baby is going to look like. Oh my goodness, you look almost exactly like your father, actually. And all of these moles are popping out of the ground. I think I even heard some Krabbits spawn somewhere. We'll have to keep our eyes open for that. They must have heard that we're getting ready to move on to the Challenge Island, because we're sure to find lots of Krabbits there too. But before we do anything else, let's make sure that we take a look at this stripy little baby in the nest. Little Lossie, and she has the poison fangs too, so that's good. Unfortunately, she did not inherit the toxic body from her mother's genetics. She wasn't able to pass it on in her inactive traits, but she is super sneaky, just like her mother, and she has the most gorgeous stripes too. They almost look like little wings, tiny little wings right on her forehead. So maybe that's a good sign that she'll pick up those bluebird feathers after all. We'll have to see though. We'll have to see what sort of creature Lossie is going to end up being, because she might not be suited to the role of leadership, or it might take her an extra long time before she accepts it, just like Ronuta. If there's any creature who feels fully prepared for her mission though, it is definitely Ruby. So let's bring you over here to finally, hopefully, swipe up the berry bush. She's still not quite strong enough to truly take it down in one swipe. So this is definitely going to be some pretty good training for you. Maybe your mother could even help you out by landing a couple of punches in herself, just to show you the right way. Because we want to make sure you're totally prepared to become our first little guardian. It looks like the gang is all officially here though. We're all up in the north, right around the swamplands. So in the next episode, we're going to make our very final preparations. We'll choose all 10 of the creatures who will be leaving with us for the next island, and we'll get ourselves just one step closer to finally seeing Adam's old family too. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye guys!